goodness.
Go ahead.
Best wishes. Okay, well, continue to keep God first in your life, and as you serve Him, and as I'm not ready, like I'm just doing. Continue to put God first in your life. I'm so proud of you, Jazz. And as you serve the Lord and serve your husband, remember you're serving the Lord. And as you're serving the Lord, you're also serving your husband. I'm so proud of you. I love you so much. I'm gonna miss you, but I'm gonna always see you. It's just awesome. Just awesome to see how God has been working in your life and how He's gonna continue working in your life. I love you, Jess.
Thank you.
You're the best. Wow, we've made it this far. This is so crazy. We're getting married. I love you so much, and I can't wait to start this journey with you and to overcome all our obstacles, to make each other better, to make each other stronger through Christ, and to love each other until the end of time. I can't wait to see more.
Shoulder when you cry, I hear your voice.
recognizing what he has done for us. And so marriage is God's idea. And he's given us this earthly marriage so that we can understand him better. Well, now we're getting into the way God thinks. Because God's love is an other-oriented love. So he's given us marriage so that we can understand him. So some people have said, Pastor, I've never understood that before. I hope that that starts to bring great meaning to every husband and wife that you see, whether or not they even understand that. That is God's design. And then he shows us in the great design of bringing the church to himself, that we would come to know him. So this great mystery of Christ in the church is a beautiful thing. And today, as Jessica and Keith are married, they want us to see this connection. And so we come to this. Let me also remind you that in a few moments, they are going to make vows to one another. They are going to say things to each other and to God. And you are a part of that because you are a witness to their vows. And so it is your opportunity to, number one, not only benefit from hearing what they say for your own life, but it's your opportunity to benefit their life, that in the years to come, when she's mad at him or he's mad at her, you can look at him and say, I was there that day. And so all of us are designed to help them be a godly marriage. Does that make sense? So that's our role. That's our task as their friends, as their family, as people who pray for them. And so what a great opportunity in each one of us as we participate. Father in heaven, we want to give to you this ceremony. Lord, this is not a photo op. This is not merely a family gathering. In the ultimate sense of the word, this is a family beginning. Lord, here we are in the birth room of a family. When we walk out of this room today, there will be another family born. Not only in giving us marriage, but Lord, in giving Keith and Jessica to one another. Lord, we thank you for them. Father, I thank you that they both have a clear Christian testimony of faith in Jesus and a commitment to follow after, Lord, what you have said. And so, Lord, I pray that as they come together today, that they would be able to glorify you in a new way that they've never done before. I pray for them and I pray for us that we too would be challenged in our understanding of the meaning of marriage, that we would be challenged in the understanding of what true love is like and commitment. And Father, I pray that we would honor you as you have designed. In the glorious name of Christ, we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
Lucas is going to come and read Genesis chapter 2. This is part of that first wedding in the Bible.
And with Keith and Jessica through premarital counseling. We did it in 3 weeks, but we normally do in 3 months. So I've been seeing them a lot, and it's been such a joy to see them consider that marriage is for the glory of God. The text that you have in front of you is the text that we started with every week, either in Genesis 1 or Genesis 2. Because I wanted them to see that marriage is not part of the fall. Marriage is part of the perfect created order of God. So we celebrate in the culture today that rejects it. We celebrate it as God's good gift. Now look at how God gave a good gift to Adam and his wife Eve and brought them together in this text. It says, "So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man. And while he slept, took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord gave had taken form, had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, 'This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man.' Therefore, a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh."
Forever seems like a long time, but nothing seems like a long time.
Stand right here in the middle, and I'm going to ask you all a question, each one of you, and this is an important question. I'm going to ask Jessica first. Jessica, you can look at me for a second, because you're answering me on this, and all of us. Jessica, do you take Keith to be your husband? Do you live together in covenant marriage? Will you love him? Will you comfort him? Will you honor him? Will you respectfully follow him in forsaking all others? Will you be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Keith, we have the same type question for you. What is your intention today? And here is the question. Keith, do you take Jessica to be your wife? Do you take her to live together in covenant marriage? Will you love her? Will you comfort her, honor her, and sacrificially protect her in forsaking all others? Will you be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Well, here we are. We're at this moment of God bringing the two of you together, and that we would recognize that this is a gift from God. And this is where we recognize that, Keith, the Bible says that when a man has found a wife, he's found a good thing. And I think that you would agree with that. And all of us would say that you're about to marry way over your head. because she is a good thing. And this is a blessing. And we want to recognize that this earthly marriage that you all are about to partake in, and that you're going to live for the decades ahead, this is really a classroom for loving God. This is a classroom where you're going to learn how God loves, because you're going to be challenged to give up your own rights and your own self for the other. And so now this is the classroom of God's love, and you're going to live in that. Because the way he loves is good. Ephesians 5 says that this is going to mirror how he feels about the church. So just as Christ loves the church and lays down his life for the church, Keith is called to lay down his life for you. He's called to not look out after his own interests first. He's called to look after yours. And you're called to love him and honor him and respect him. This is a beautiful symbiotic relationship that God does with us. Jesus lays down his life for us, and we are called to respect him, to follow him, and to obey him. And so this is a good design that God has made. So Keith, I'm going to charge you to cherish Jessica. No one else can love her the way God has meant for you to love her. No one else will be able to make her feel more valuable. No one else will be able to make her feel less valuable than you. Not even her mom and her dad anymore. This is God's design. And no one, Jessica, will be able to make him feel more like a respectable man than you. You will now have the power over him to make him feel like he could conquer the world. I know he looks like he can physically, but in all seriousness, you will have this power over him to cause him to be all that he can be, or you will be able to make him feel like an utter failure. It's a strange power that a wife has over us. And so as you cherish her and she respects you, you're, by God's design, able to help one another be all that God has intended for you to be. So be careful with that power. Use it correctly. Use it for God's glory and for your good. And there's a bunch of people sitting out here in the crowd and saying, why didn't anybody tell me that? I would have liked to have done that 30 years ago. But this is the way God has made it. So now we come to the vows, where you commit your love to one another. Ecclesiastes 5:4, God's word tells us, when you make a vow, don't be late in paying it. So especially when you make a vow to God. And what we're doing here today is that you're about making a vow to one another, that these vows are made in the sight of God, and they are made to Him as well. And so, the first one we come to is you're already holding each other's hands, and that is a good thing. And Keith, I now ask you to lead in making this vow. So, whereas she was the first to give her consent, now it's you're the first one to make the vow. And so repeat after me. I, Keith, take you, Jessica.
I, Keith, take you, Jessica.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part. According to God's holy law. And in His presence I make this vow. Jessica, repeat after me these vows. I, Jessica, take you, Keith.
I, Jessica, take you, Keith.
To be my husband. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish till death do us part.
To love and to cherish till death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's
law. And in His presence I make this vow.
His presence I make this vow.
Amen. From time throughout history, people have used rings as a symbol. And so now you're going to exchange rings with one another. Do you have rings? Great. We're going to start with Keith. Keith, would you take this ring and place it on Jessica's ring finger there to go with that engagement diamond? As you look at that ring, Keith, and as you hold it on her hand, I want you to recognize that this right here is a symbol of this covenant marriage. A ring is a circle, which means it has no end. And at least for your lives here, what you've committed to one another is that my love is not going to end. It's going to continue as this ring stays with me and proclaims my commitment to you. So, Keith, would you repeat after me? Jessica, I give you this ring.
Jessica, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage covenant.
As a sign of our marriage covenant.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I have, I give to you.
All that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son and the Holy Spirit. Jessica, take that ring and place it on Keith's finger there. The ring that you're giving him is a strong, powerful metal. It doesn't react with everything else. It's a metal that is very non-reactive. It is a metal that really stays pure. Very often they're gold or platinum or some other type of special alloy. In this picture, it is a valuable symbol. And so, with that symbol being given, would you say these words? Keith, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage covenant. With my body, I honor you. And all that I have, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let's pray together. Father, we have just said some very important words here. Keith and Jessica have said important words here. And it's through this commitment of love that they now become not just two individuals, but one couple. Father, we thank you that you have given us a good design, and it proclaims the gospel. Lord, that every husband, every wife in their marriage, this is a representation of your marriage to us. And so, Father, I pray that you would bless this marriage. I pray, Father, that you would bless them with the strength and the joy and the grace that they need for the years to come. Lord, we recognize that there will be times of great joy, and there will be times of great glory together as they enjoy life together. And Lord, we also recognize that there's going to be challenges. There are going to be hard times. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. And so, Lord, I pray that their covenant together today and their love for one another today will hold fast in their hearts as they see that you hold fast to your people, that you do not let them go. Lord, that you hold us. None can be lost from your hand. And so, Lord, I pray that their love would be like that. Lord, I pray that if you would bless this union with children, Lord, that their children from here in this place, Lord, would be committed to you as children from a Christian home. Lord, we pray that their children would come to know you, really because of what they see in their mom and dad, a genuine faith and a commitment not only to one another but to God. Lord, I pray that their children's children would also come to know you and love you, and that this would be a heritage of faith in this family. Father, we pray for this in the strong name of Jesus. Your bride.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Keith and Jessica Sumo.
Father-daughter dance.
Oh, yeah.
And I knew for sure I was loved.
You'll be good, baby. You're okay. It's okay. It's okay.
To dance with my father again.
Enter into one unit together. We're going to get a little insight into their lives and get to know this couple a little better. So Keith is going to have a seat. This is their first argument. Let's see what happens. Okay, Jessica's going to have a seat right here in this chair. Keith is going to have a seat in the chair right here. And they're both going to take off their shoes. And they're going to hand one of their shoes to their now spouse. Keith, I'm glad you showered this morning. So what we're going to do is they're going to have one of their shoes and one of their spouse's shoes in their hands. And what they're going to do is we're going to ask them a series of questions. And whoever is most likely to, and we'll fill in the blank, they will raise the person's shoe. So Jessica, take off your other shoe, hand one of them to Keith. Keith, take off your other shoe as well. You're going to keep one and hand one to Jessica.
Yeah.
You okay?
All right, so we're going to start off with some easy ones, okay?
Oh, boy.
Who is the better driver?
Oh.
Okay, put your shoes down. Okay. Not, you can't look.
Oh, man.
Okay?
You have to wait for the video.
I mean, all of that.
Who is the better cook?
Whoa.
Okay. Who is more forgetful?
Actually,
my son.
Who is more clumsy?
No.
Who is more likely to be late for an event?
Jess.
She was on time for my way. She was on time for my way.
Things that matter.
Who is more likely? Who is more likely to make an impulsive purchase?
Guilty.
Who is more likely, or I'm sorry, who is better with directions? More likely to be the cool parent?
I think I'm cool.
Who was interested in who first? Who said, "I love you" first? Who is more likely to plan a romantic date?
Yeah.
Who is more likely to go skydiving? Who is more likely to go scuba diving? And last question. Final question. Are you ready for it?
No, but.
Who's going to get first?
Send it. Who, what?
Who goes to bed first?
Tonight.
Tonight?
Alrighty, sounds good. Alright, you guys can put your shoes back on. So, why Jessica and Keith put their shoes back on, we're going to ask all the single ladies to please come and stand in the floor right here for the bouquet talk. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, as the couple finish cutting the cake and we get the cake all cut, I just want to remind you that we have the guest book right here, so if you did not sign in, the couple would like to know that you all were here on this special day with them. And also, right over here on the table, they have date ideas. They have a lot of quarantine time to get to know each other, and they want some date ideas for when this is all over. So make sure to fill out a date card. And also, there's some refreshments over there. So again, make yourselves feel at home and make sure to fill out a card.
Here we are, we found the day, like we always prayed. The way that God intended for us. Make these hearts entwined with yours, Jesus, lead the way. What we've seen, all that we've learned, built up to this day. And our Father's spoken, in this life we've chosen, will help us follow your
path.
I confess that I understand it, but I see me holding your hand.
And we're going to actually make a kind of a line outside of kind of a see them offline as you go as they're headed to their car. So you guys can kind of start to make your way this way.
Thank you.